What's poppin', y'all? Zach here, and today I'm gonna show you the top 15 watchOS 4 features and updates in this video. And that's all coming up. Nothing can stop me, I'm all the way up. Alright, so another feature that Apple introduced was when you're setting up your Apple Watch, when you're pairing it, you got there's an easy pairing, so when you bring your Apple Watch close to the iPhone, it recognizes and pulls up a section like this, and then you just pair and then you scan it and then you're all good to go. And while you're setting up your iPhone, there's tips for you while you're setting it up. So you talk about the digital crown, the side button, and how you can scroll as quick as possible. And then this is the installation page, and I'll just go through it with you while we're at it. So there's a new screen on Apple Watch. It's just showing you. It's actually better because people can look through it and you can see what the Apple Watch is about and what it can do. So, but it's really laggy and it doesn't, you know, show up straight away. It just says tap to select, and then it just says press firmly. So just a few little hints Apple gives you. And then next, we've got digital crown and what it does. So digital crown is just press to return, press and hold. So you can do all these little functions with them, and then turn it when you have like a text to read or something. And then the side button, it's actually called the side button. Wow. Press to shut down, of course, or press to show the dock, and then double click to Apple Pay, which is really handy. I use it. And press and hold for the medical ID as well, which is cool. And then also,
alright, so another feature that Apple introduced was the list view. So when you force press on the home, you get the list view. I kind of prefer this sometimes, but you know, it makes it easier for you to find stuff so you can scroll through it. But just to stay in the Apple vibe, Apple Watch, just stay on the grid view. So that's another feature. And another feature is the new watch faces. So there's plenty of Apple Watch faces that is happening, and the current one that I'm facing right now is the Siri. It's pretty good. It's got the Siri up there, you can activate straight away, you can customize the Siri and that top button right there. But it just pulls up your calendar here and shows you the weather and yeah, various things like standing up time, the news, take a break, and yeah, it just goes through the whole day. I'm sure you've heard about this. And there's also other Apple Watch faces, such as, so you can now, there's another feature, like you scroll through now, instead of flicking like this, you can use the digital crown to skip through. So kaleidoscopic is another feature which Apple has recently added on watchOS 4. So as you can see, you can just spin through the digital crown until you like something. I like that right there. And there's various things you can do. What else is there? There's a Toy Story as well. So there's a Toy Story Apple Watch face. Hopefully, there we go. It's kind of cool. Where's it going? Come back. Yeah. Maybe whenever you're pulling up your Apple Watch, it does something. Oh, here we go. They're kind of cool and hilarious. Did you see that? Sunday 20th, changed to green. I think I kind of like the Toy Story Apple Watch faces. Every time you pull it up, you get something exciting. It's not showing now, but let's see if I can get a show. There's a whole pack. There's all of them. Let's see if I can get it again. Oh, you tap on it. There's another one. So there's different things. Oh! Let's play another one. Here we go. Toy Story Apple Watch face. There's a lot of animations, which is pretty cool. Another one. Uh oh. That's pretty cool. Spotlight. Oops. Showing you the time. I'm kind of liking this one. I'll leave that on there. So there's also, if you go into your phone, if you go into your phone app and you got a new keypad where it works the same as that one. There's no sound. So you get the whole idea. Or you can add a number there. It's another feature. And there's also, of course, the news app that Apple introduced. So you get the whole, you get like a news app, but you can save it for later. And you can just save it here and it will show me on the news Apple Watch. Maybe I'll get a notification reminding me to read it later. So you can swipe through them. That's another app. So the workout app has been updated as well. It is my favorite and I've been using it because I go to the gym every now and then. And before we didn't have the strength training there, so I just put it on others. But right now, as you can see, my last workout is strength training. So if I click on that, it should straight away start it. There you go. And then you get the icon, the workout guy, strength training, or if you're cycling, be cycling. If you're swimming, you'll be swimming. So then you get a heart rate. Everything is just new. And then if you go here, you can add a new one, and you can play your music, turn the volume up and down. So pretty legit, easy ones. And then yeah, there's a whole list of, you know, number of new high intensity is a new one that they have added as well. So that's the workout app has been updated as well. So it's got my heart rate for the past 24 hours. Okay, should have it. I was reading, put up a watch and put it through. Okay, it wants it to be in the wrist and then it'll show the thing, but you'll have your 24 hour heart rate there, which is pretty cool as well. So for instance, if I was gonna play something on my phone, let's say, let's just go, I'm gonna go to YouTube, you can see, and I'm just gonna play, let's say, I'm gonna play this.
Lexian.
Alright, so that's playing on my phone, and then, alright, here we go. So it's telling me what's up next, but where's the whole interface? Or maybe here. Here you go, now playing. So I can turn the volume up.
She's not my friend.
She's my old friend, Melisandre.
Turn it down. Stop it. That's it, that's the YouTube interface, but you can use it with Apple Watch, everything. Which is cool. I mean, that's Apple Music. The Maps app has been updated as well. I'll just quickly get you through. It's just slightly changed. So gathering and suggestions. So it's getting Siri suggestions. So I've been there recently. Everything new here. And then you can search your location. Okay, so...
Alright, so one of the features that I wanted Apple to update, well, I had a lot of issues as well with, was when you were trying to, you know, punch in a number and you wasn't sure if you pressed the right one or not. But now when you press a number, it pops out like that, as you can see. It pops out and it has a new sound, and there's a new delete sound as well. So alright, that's all the features that I have, but there's tons more you can look through and find. You can comment down below and write your favorite ones. And that'll be it for today, and I'm working on a new video where I'll be showing you the best apps to use on your Apple Watch on watchOS 4. So that's the whole video. That's the video for today, and another video is I'm on the whole process. I'm searching for it, I'm researching, and I'll get that video ready as soon as possible. So make sure you subscribe and like this video, and there's more to come in the future. So that's it for me today. Catch you later.